Okay, good evening, everybody, and welcome to the September 21st, 2023 Collegium Charter School Board of Trustees public meeting. This meeting has been advertised as required by Pennsylvania law and the bylaws of the Board of Trustees, with the date, time, and location published in the Daily Local News on the Collegium website and as part of the Collegium calendar. I ask that we now please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, Chris McHenry is here. Mr. Baxter?
Present.
Mr. Randall is absent. Work conflict, as is Mr. Brown. And Mr. Girardo?
Present.
Thank you. We do have a quorum. My understanding is there were no public comments received on agenda items. And is there anyone here that wishes to make any comments? Seeing no one moving. Is there a motion to accept the agenda?
So moved.
Second?
Oh, second.
Thanks, Rob.
Did we say that last time?
Yep. Okay, any comments or questions or changes to the agenda?
No.
Hearing none, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposition or abstention? Very well, the agenda is approved. In your packet are the minutes from the August 17th, 2023 meeting. Is there a motion to approve these minutes?
So moved.
And a second?
Second.
Any discussion, comments, or amendments to the minutes?
No.
Hearing none? Is it all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposition, any abstention? Normally, this would be the time for the high school student representative report. They were unable to attend tonight, so we'll move forward to business and operations. First up are the financial reports. Mr. McEnany.
Motion.
Oh, yes. Is there a motion to consider the business and operations items?
So moved.
And a second? Robert?
Second. Sorry, I keep forgetting.
Thank you. Okay, Dave. And still compliant with all the bonds then. Any questions regarding the financial statements?
No.
Okay. The emergency capital request for the HVAC unit? Any questions regarding the capital request?
So emergency, is it functioning?
Right now, I believe it's not functioning. They had to shut it down because of a leak.
It's also considered an emergency request because it's not part of the capital budget for the year. It's over and above.
Yeah, I was thinking for, I mean, if it's not functioning and we need it, then it makes sense. Just thinking with being at 55 days cash on hand, we're still a little unsure where things are coming to stay above the bond covenants, but if we need it, we need it.
Well, one day's cash is roughly
$168,000.
Yeah.
No, I get it.
Okay.
Yeah. And I'll be honest with you, we just got three very large payments since August 31st. So we're
That is true. Yeah,
yeah, like summer, we really pound the money going out.
That makes sense.
Okay, and then the last item in business and operations is a resolution that will allow the school CEO to sign newly approved and renewed contracts, those of which that need a board approval will, of course, have board approval first, not to exceed $150,000. This kind of cleans things up a little bit, allows the board to approve, and then Rita can sign them when needed to speed things up a little bit. There's no questions on that. All in favor of approving the business and operations items, please say aye.
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 Any opposition? Any abstention? There are no curriculum instruction and assessment items this month. We do have the personnel report to approve. Do you have that?
Yeah, do you want to do the motion? I do have it.
Is there a motion to consider the personnel report?
So moved.
Second.
Second. Thank you.
So contained in the packet is the summary of new hires and position and building changes, as well as separations and leave of absence since the August meeting. This time of year is still one of the busiest for interviewing and continuing to hire. We're reporting 20 new hires and 11 position or building changes, and then 9 separations and 6 leaves of absence. When we look at the current level of open positions, we still find our biggest need is in support staff positions. And we're at about, we're still looking for about 12% of faculty positions. But HR department continues to do an amazing job of identifying potential candidates and moving the processes along as quickly as possible. And as Diane pointed out last week, the building administrative teams have been wonderful as far as providing coverages and looking for creative solutions and the sharing any kind of extra subs that might be on campus between buildings to cover some openings still.
Any questions on the personnel report? All right, hearing none, all in favor say aye.
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 And any opposed or abstentions? Very well. Is there a motion to consider the policy item, which is a revision to the uniform policy?
So moved.
Second.
Thank you.
So the proposed revision is really under the safety of the footwear section, just trying to be relevant and responsive to what we know the shoes our students have, but really when we look at safety, to make sure that they are just standard flat shoes or sneakers and should be something with a back, no slide slippers, sandals, or flip-flops.
Any questions on the revisions to the uniform policy?
No.
Okay. Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
And any opposed or abstentions? Well, next on the schedule is an executive session update.
No executive sessions since our last meeting.
Do any of the board members have any new business to consider or discuss? No remarks for general remarks were received.
Correct.
Through the email. Is there anybody here in person that would like to make any remarks? Any additional comments for the good of the order from the trustees? Okay. Hearing none, is there a motion for adjournment?
So moved.
Second.
And a second. Thank you. All in favor say aye.
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 And no abstentions, no noes. Very well. That concludes the meeting. And we will be back in October for our regular work session and public meetings.
Correct.
Thank you all very much.
Thank you.
Thanks, everyone.